First, let me clarify my point. I repeat this again and again, three theses. The first one, the main responsibility for the refugee crisis lies with us, the West, the Western powers. At two levels, we have this responsibility. First, the economic one. Again, I always mention this country, which is the ultimate horror for me today, Congo, Republic of Congo. It's a country very wealthy, coltan other minerals, and it's presented as kind of a heart of darkness. Yeah, but this heart of darkness is fully included into global economy. In this, you know, all those local warlords there are selling the stuff to mineral companies, whatever. What I want to say is this, that this decay, ruin, failed states in Africa, this is not just some primitivism there. It's clearly, it's elementary, to quote Sherlock Holmes. It's linked to the way global capitalism relates to, exploits, whatever you say, those countries. For example, I can tell you that, imagine that all the minerals disappear from the ground of Congo. I claim it would have been, and this is the tragedy for them, a much more peaceful, better state. And it's the same in many other countries. When we hear about religious conflicts and so on, usually there are Western interests behind and so on and so on. So first we should talk openly, frankly, about what, for the lack of better term, we can call economic neo-colonialism. And nobody is clean here. We shouldn't blame only the West. For example, I celebrate China. It's incredible what economic success they are. But the way they are acting recently in some African countries, Latino American countries, and others, it's clear absolute economic neocolonialism also. So they are also doing it. Or another horrible thing for me. You know what some Asian countries and Arab countries here, exceptionally, we are not so guilty. Like, I think South Korea is doing it, Saudi Arabia and so on. They are buying large tracts of the best fertile land in some African countries, from Mozambique to Madagascar, even in Somalia, sorry, not Somalia, but Eritrea and so on. And they use it mostly even for industrial plants to export and so on. I mean, this is one, the economic aspect. Second aspect are these geopolitical interventions, war, and so on, and so on. To tell, without military American intervention in Iraq, to cut a long story short, there wouldn't have been ISIS, there wouldn't have been what goes on now in Syria. Without the stupid Western intervention in Libya, there wouldn't have been what is going on now in Libya, and so on and so on. This is for me elementary, especially I want to emphasize the tragedy of Iraq. It's almost a comical tragedy, the ultimate stupidity. Namely, Americans intervened, and incidentally, this is one of the very dark chapters of American feminism. Nancy Fraser wrote a good book on it, how many American feminists supported American intervention. It will bring freedom from Muslim oppression to women of Iraq, where unfortunately it's the exact opposite. Because whatever Saddam was, and he was a monster, his regime up to the end, when he started to flirt with Islam to get support, his regime was basically Arab nationalist secular one. And at least his record with women was way above the usual Arab standards. Women got many public posts, they were educated, and so on and so on. This is now the situation of women as the result of American intervention is much worse. There is another paradox. Under Saddam, there were around 2 million of Christians in Iraq. Who, if they didn't mess with politics, of course. They, no problem, they lived there. Now, the result of American occupation, because the public order, police, disintegrated and Islamic Muslim militias took over, and Christians began to feel the pressure. Already around, I think, 3/4 of Christians left the country. So that's the result. Much worse situation for women. And it's nice irony. A Western Christian country invades Iraq, and the result is Christians are out. I mean, no, what Islam was not able to do in thousands of years and so on. So what I'm saying is that all this background has to be taken into account, but there is a but. Don't, on the other hand, don't patronize the Arabs in the sense of, you know, it's very popular in Europe, this, how do I call it, masochist leftist attitude. Whenever something bad happens in the third world, it must be the consequence of neocolonialism. We are to be blamed and so on and so on. No, this is stupid. I'm sorry to tell you. Arabs are not just passive victims. They have certain projects. They are, I speak like Sartre here. We are never just passive participants in a situation. We react even when we are in a worse situation through certain, let's call it, existential project. So I think that this type of self-culpability, we are responsible for everything and so on and so on, it's not such a simple. For example, what Saudi Arabia, let's forget about ISIS. I don't worry about so-called terror. But for example, what Saudi Arabia is doing and some other countries, it's clearly not that they are victims. It's a well-defined religious political project.